Welcome all of you to this video. In the previous video, we learned about parallelograms and its features. Today in this video, we will study about some special parallelograms. The teacher in the class asked the children to identify this figure. Can you tell what shape it is? Think. Well done. Opposite sides are parallel and of equal measure. And the opposite angles are also of equal measure. Hence, the figure shown is a parallelogram.
Ramesh, Raju and Meena. Now, you also make a parallelogram.
Ramesh, Raju and Meena make these figures.
Now, can you tell me how you have drawn your own figure? Ramesh, tell me first.
Teacher, I know that in parallelogram, the opposite sides are of parallel and of equal measure. So, I made this parallelogram with the help of these four sides of equal measure, in which the opposite angles are also equal.
Very good, Ramesh. All the sides of this parallelogram are of equal measure. Therefore, we can call it a special parallelogram. Do you all know its name? It is a rhombus. Let me tell you an important thing related to the rhombus. If we make a special kind of kite-shaped figure whose forearms are of equal measure, then you can see that we get such shape. Now, if we fold the shape respectively with respect to both its diagonals, we find that the triangles formed on folding are mutually congruent, from which we can conclude that the angles in this shape are equal. Also, if we fold this quadrilateral with respect to the lines connecting the middle points of its sides MN and OP and the sides NO and MP respectively, you can see that the sides NO and MP and MN and OP are parallel. This means the opposite sides of this shape are of equal measures and parallel to each other, and we have just seen that its opposite angles are of equal measure, which makes this shape a rhombus.
But we made this shape with the help of a kite. So, what do you think about this rhombus now?
Teacher, we can say that the rhombus is a shape that has the characteristics of both the parallelogram and the kite. If we discuss its diagonals, we will find that both of its diagonals are not of equal measure, but they bisect each other.
Perfect. So let's now write the characteristics of rhombus with the help of these two figures, which are as follows. Come on, Raju. Now discuss the figure you have made. Tell me, how did you make this shape?
I have created this shape keeping in mind all the features of the parallelogram. But in this figure, I have drawn all the right angles. Is it a parallelogram?
Yes, Raju, it is a parallelogram, but it becomes a special type of parallelogram because all its angles are right angles, and we call this particular parallelogram a rectangle. If we draw the triangles PQR and SRQ appearing in this rectangle separately on another paper and observe, you can see that both triangles are congruent, with the help of which we can say that both diagonals of the rectangle are of equal measure. So, now what can you say about the rectangle?
We can say that the rectangle is a parallelogram whose all angles are the right angles and the diagonals are of equal measure and the diagonals bisect each other.
Well done, Meena. Let us now see the shape you have made. Tell me, how did you make it?
Teacher, I have made a parallelogram whose four sides measure equal and all the angles are right angles. Is this also a special type of parallelogram?
Yes, Meena. We call such a parallelogram square. We can also call a square a rectangle that has the same measure of all arms. Since the opposite sides of the square are parallel and all the sides are of equal measure and the opposite angles are also of equal measure, these characteristics of the square correspond to the characteristics of the rhombus. Therefore, we can say that the square is a quadrilateral in which all the features of the parallelogram, rhombus and rectangle are present. So kids, can you tell me about the characteristics of square on this basis?
Sir, all the arms in the square are of equal measure. The opposite sides are parallel. All angles are right angles. And since it is also a rhombus, its diagonals are perpendicular to each other.
Very good, Raju.
Today in this video, we learned about rhombus, rectangles and squares along with their characteristics. In the next video, we will see some examples based on these.